Hey guys, welcome back. Today we are super excited about starting our kitchen dormer project. This is going to be a big one for us.
It is. The window we got for this one was also a free window, which is great.
Yes.
It's 10.5 feet long by 5.5 feet tall.
Yes.
So keep in mind, if we have a cabinet down low, it's going to be roughly 36 inches. Plus we can get 5.5 feet up. That's all window space, so that damn thing's going to be pretty big coming off the top of that roof coming down.
Yeah, it is. We really loved how the smaller dormer that we put in for the utility room turned out, so we're really excited about this one, especially the view that we're going to get with that amazing window. So.
Plus, it's going to add a lot more space, too.
It is.
It is. Great.
Yep. So let's get started. Let's see if we can knock this out in hopefully a couple of days. We don't want to leave the house exposed to the elements for too long, so we're trying to get it shut back in.
Yep. All right. Let's go.
All right. Make our cuts. These cuts are going to be 11 feet up off of the floor, so this is going to be a big dormer for us. If you remember from our previous video on how we did our smaller dormer in the utility room, we decided to do these after the build. Our reason for that is we were not sure exactly of how our measurements were going to be, and we didn't want to waste a lot of material and wood in our 2x12s. So all of these 2x12s are going to have the exact correct cut. We're going to be able to reuse them for the beams on either side of the dormer as well as the top. And our only wasted material are going to be a couple of sheets of OSB, which is a lot less expensive. So that's why we are doing these dormers after the fact. And now we're ready to get cutting.
Great job, something like that, Joey. You sparked me nails in the throat. I think you see it, Dennis. Whatever.
Okay, so now that we have all the OSB down, all the nails and the lag bolts removed, we're ready to start cutting down these 2x12s. So we've got 4 2x12s on this side. They're gonna get scooted over that way to support this beam for the dormer. And these 4 2x12s are gonna get scooted over this way to form the beam for this side of the dormer. And then we're gonna start building the beam that's gonna go across the top.
See all this brush over here, all this brush and all these stumps, that all came from actually clearing this property right here to put the house on. Eventually, we're gonna go through, we're gonna burn it all. All this stuff's gonna be made for firewood, and whatever little brush is, we'll do a fire, we'll burn it, and we'll be gone.
Yeah.
This time nothing.
brought them over to the saw, cut them down to 11 and a quarter, and put them back right here so that they would build up and support the beam that we are getting ready to place across the top for the dormer.
Right here, good? 13 foot 10 3/4 inch. That should give me a little wiggle room to get it in. Just a little bit. You got it, right?
Yes.
All right, good.
Framing up this one front wall for the window.
Go. Got it. I'm looking your side.
Good, I'm going past.